What are the etiquettes of burying the deceased and what you should be saying after burying as opposed to what the sister described?
Yes, I mean, when the time the body is lowered into the grave, remember that is the time after the sand and the dust have been thrown into the grave. You know, we say minha khalaqnakum wa fiha nu'idukum wa minha nukhrijukum taratan ukhra. After this procedure, there comes the next stage where a people and the families are standing, and this is the time where we reflect on the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, istaghfiru li akhikum fa innahu al-an tus'al. Now you make istighfar. You make, even if you ask for thabat and firmness, pray that Allah Ta'ala grants him thabat. Allah Ta'ala grants firmness, because now he has been questioned, and these are the questions in the grave. Man rabbuka, ma dinuka, man hadha rajulu. The three questions that every person will be asked in the qabr, in the grave. Who is your Rabb? What is your deen? Who is this person? The grave is not an ordinary place. You know, if there were any person to be saved from the compression of the grave, it would have been Sa'd radiallahu anhu, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But indeed, it is a very difficult moment in time, and when the grave compresses, and then there is the questions where you have, as you said, Munkar and Nakir. So you have to make istighfar, you have to pray. There are those who are standing there because this is a time of questioning in the grave. And when a person is complete that stage of the answering of the question, then that grave becomes a garden of the Garden of Jannah. So we have to make dua that Allah Ta'ala save us all from the punishment of the grave and make the grave a garden of the Garden of Jannah. So yes, indeed, one can stand there and continue praying and making dua. Don't just bury and then leave. Stay there for a while, as long as you can. Jazakallah khairan.